Also part of the package is a great cargo area. I bring your attention to the fact that this is a five-door, so it opens up the rear of that. We moved the subwoofers out of the space. Overall, it has a lot of room for this passive vehicle. Unexpectedly, a lot of the utility and the practicality of this vehicle. It's about a 23.3 overall cubic feet with the seats up. It's a split folding 60-40. If you have longer items like skis or golf clubs, you can drop one half, get a little bit more room. If you drop both halves, it goes up to a 40.9. It's very, very practical. More importantly, though, is the fact that this is a fairly large opening on which to develop a sports performance vehicle. And the main point here is, of course, you basically have a giant hole right on top of the body where the suspension has to do all its work. So there was a lot of engineering work. It was a major, major challenge. It was a big battle with engineering to get this done. They stepped up to the challenge. We're happy to report and deliver probably one of the stiffest and most complete chassis that we have, which is really, really the backbone and the key ingredient in delivering that premium feel, that driving feel, and also the level of sophistication and overall ambiance that you would expect in this category. A lot of the work was CAD data, but also the basic ingredients. We've used about 55% advanced and also an ultra advanced high strength steel. And the benefit here, of course, is we have our own in-house metal sourcing. We have about 110 metallurgists on staff that work directly with the body structure engineers to optimize the use of this material, which is really, really a key point. One of the other ones is extensive use of structural adhesives all through the vehicle to really get that firm type feel that we were looking for. And with that, the advent of the fact that this is a five-door, it meant there was a lot of work to incorporate this material into the vehicle. Of course, we had full visibility of all of the latest safety standards. We were able to engineer this into the vehicle from the beginning, so we're anticipating highest results, top safety pick from NHTSA and IIHS. All of these test protocols were built into the vehicle from the beginning. A little bit more about the overall performance. We're going to market with two powertrains. The first one is a 2-liter turbocharged engine. It's a twin-scroll design, 255 horsepower, 0-60 in 5.9 seconds. We use this engine in an FF transverse configuration in some of our other cars, the Optima, Sorento, and the other ones have this. This is our first longitudinal application. It was designed and tuned specifically for this application. The second engine is a twin turbo 3.3 liter V6. I bring your attention to the moniker here. This we reserved the GT moniker just for the V6 model, so there will be some differentiation in the marketplace. The four cylinder is just referred to as a Stinger. For the V6, it's 365 horsepower, 0 to 60 miles per hour. We announced back in January when we showed it at the Detroit Auto Show, 5.1. And we challenged the engineers to see if they could improve over that to get it under 5 seconds. They worked very diligently through the spring and over the summer, and I'm happy to show the results. They're now down to 4.7 seconds, 0 to 60 with this engine. It's a remarkable accomplishment. We're really proud of that.
What did they do?
We just a lot of tuning, a lot of work. They optimized exhaust flow, updated the cam profiles, a lot of small little details. It's a whole host of probably 100 different changes that made changes throughout the vehicle to improve that performance. Both of these are backed by our own design and built in-house HP transmission. The benefit here, of course, is that powertrain engineers, both the engine and the transmission guys, were able to work very closely together and optimize this powertrain specifically for the application in this vehicle.
That's a torque converter?
Yes. This is just one other point on the Nürburgring. James mentioned about how difficult it is. This was a new engineering challenge for both our engineers because we've never used this level of test protocol to develop. And it's a very, very demanding course. It's high speed. It's a lot of full throttle, full braking over an extended period of time. We had to up our engineering game in many areas. We put this example up here just to show one of the specific areas, which is the powertrain cooling. A lot of work went into making sure that the vehicle can endure this level of performance at this for this length of time. Points such as a very powerful brushless fan motor. We developed two new systems for external engine oil and also transmission oil cooling. The overall cooling profile and envelope for the vehicle has been increased overall to perform at that level on an extended basis. So that basically drives a lot of engineering knowledge into the system overall. The benefit between developing a five-door body style and also this very rugged test protocol has really increased our engineering acumen across the board. And the payoff for us expected going forward is a lot of our vehicles will perform at a much higher level relative to its competitive set. One of the first examples, a couple of weeks ago, we were in Baltimore. We demonstrated the brand new Rio, our new B car, into the segment. And I think a lot of the media and the journalists were surprised how well put together the car was. And that's one of the payoffs for developing a car of this caliber, is that engineering ability improves across all of the other vehicles at the same time. That's a really key point. I think that's helping out overall. Same story for the brakes. This is a Brembo brake package. It's a four-piston fixed caliper system, great swept area. More importantly, we've added a couple of new features. Brake fade compensation, also part of this Nürburgring protocol, is the fact that there's a lot of brake fade involved. We've developed a lot of work to minimize this as much as possible. During quick maneuvers, we've also put this this new technology in where it compensates for, as the brakes get hot, typically it takes more effort and longer distances to achieve the same level of stopping. The system does this automatically. It senses, based on brake pressure, it'll automatically boost or increase the boost during these high performance encounters to make sure that braking performance stays at a flat level. A lot of work also went into the cooling package to airflow. I've got a slide on this in a few minutes to show some of the details on it. So overall, a great system. This is just a quick snapshot of the comparison between our V6 relative to the competitive set. And if you look across the board, we basically have more power than basically both of the BMW Grand Coupes, the Porsche Panamera, and also the Audi S5 Sportback. We're at 365 if you look across the board. We basically have also from a 0 to 60, you can look across the board, our 4.7, how it stacks up. We basically beat the BMWs, the Porsche, and the Audi is just ahead of us. But look at this one. This is a really interesting one. The top speed across the board, we have the highest top speed in the category, 167 miles an hour. And we've limited it to 167, basically, because of the tires and safety. It's a really, really key point. So basically, we're quicker and more powerful than both the BMWs, the Lexus GS, and also, of course, the Panamera. A little bit more about the development of the all-wheel drive. This is, I mentioned that both of the powertrains are available, both rear-wheel drive and also all-wheel drive. This is our first FR application in a sedan with all-wheel drive. This specific system was designed specifically around Stinger. It's rear-wheel, it's rear-biased all-wheel drive. The electronically controlled clutch can move between 0 and 50% of the torque to the front axle in specific applications. It's continuously variable. I've got a slide on some of the other technology for the rear-wheel drive versions, and we have a mix of both all-wheel drive and rear-wheel drives for you to drive today. We've made available a mechanically limited slip differential on the V6 models from GKN as our supplier on that one. The all-wheel drive, we've added a system called dynamic torque vectoring. It's using the brakes. I think most of you are familiar with the technology. It applies brake pressure to the inside wheel to create drag to help maintain a line if you're accelerating out of the corner. And this technology helps pull the vehicle through that by moving the torque to the outside wheel. It's great performance for both dry conditions, inclement weather. Of course, all-wheel drive adds traction to those situations, but the payoff for all-wheel drive is a lot more stability and a quicker time through a corner because of this technology. One of the other points we've added to the vehicle, and this is some of the work that went between the transmission and the powertrain engineers, but also the chassis engineers, we've developed a new version of our drive mode select. It has five different modes. Their control is in the center console, so as you're driving, make sure that you change the different settings to feel the personality of the vehicle basically change. Here's all the parameters it controls: electronically controlled suspension, the steering, throttle response will change, also the transmission shift schedule and the shift down points. The all-wheel drive system, it changes the torque vectoring. and also the electronic stability control. Specifically in two modes, the sport mode and the custom, it changes the steering feel fairly dramatically. So the personality of the vehicle, when you put it into sport mode, really, really changes across all of these areas. So please be sure to check that out on the drive today. One of the other points I mentioned about that top speed of 167 miles an hour, when you're traveling this fast, airflow and the aerodynamics play a very, very important role. And if you just look at the general overall shape of the Stinger, it's very similar to the cross-section of a wing where the upper surface is longer than the lower surface. Well, that's basically the definition of lift. And we worked really, really hard with the and closely with the aerodynamic engineers to minimize this natural effect just because of the body shape, to minimize the amount of lift by building in areas where we can improve the downforce. As an example, we've developed this kicked up edge of the trunk lid. We looked at several different iterations of ideas on how to improve the downforce. We even looked at the Audi and Porsche system, which is using the expendable spoiler. It looks really cool to follow one of these and have it extended out, but when we look at it from an engineering and product standpoint, it's heavy, it's expensive. It's often prone to failure if you're going through snow conditions or it ices over. There's a lot of complications with it. So we worked really closely to see if we could duplicate that same level of performance without going through all that expense and technology. So this is the result. We've extended that that upper edge of the lift back there, the lift gate, to duplicate that same downforce effect that a spoiler would have in the vehicle itself. And the end result is it gives it a nice little design touch, but it's actually very functional. In addition to that, we've added some other features. I mentioned earlier about the brake cooling package. These functional vents in the front fascia, they're actually functional. Air passes through this. There's an opening on either side of the wheel opening, so it allows air to pass through this, and it goes through and improves brake cooling. But more importantly, it reduces the turbulence, that low pressure zone that forms on either side of the front wheels during fast speed. Which does two things. Number one, improves the stability, but also reduces drag for better fuel efficiency. We put this image up here. This is a full belly pan that goes from the nose just before the rear differential, fully covered. We've added a couple of NACA decks just to provide some of that cooling. This is one of the findings we found with the Nürburgring testing. Enough airflow to get in there to keep the system cool. We also added a rear diffuser to help reduce that turbulence that occurs behind the vehicle when you're traveling at high speeds. So in all, a lot of details, there's probably hundreds of these. We just put these up as examples of some of the areas that the engineers work very, very closely to help maximize its performance capabilities and also efficiency. Also new for us, our fitment is with Michelin Pilot Sport four tires. This is new for us. We're very, very proud to have this tire on us.